Okay, welcome to .com lunch here in Throwback Hall. We have a full house. We actually had 14 people RSVP, but half of them didn't show up, and the other half didn't RSVP and showed up. So we're sitting on another table now.
We still have a few more coming.
We still have a few. I believe we might break 20 today. Yeah, so it's getting bigger. It's getting bigger. Feel free to join us. You know, just come to our meetup group. The URL is on the screen right now. Sign up, join us. We have over 100 members now.
#.com life.
Okay, there we go. Maybe not.
Hi, my name is Cliff, retired Army communication officer, and just here doing the meetup with John Chow and the rest of the crew here. Thank you.
I'm Alicia. I'm in marketing communications. I work for CTABS. Our website is www.c-tabs.com, and follow us on our new social media features.
Hi, everyone. This is Mary with John Chow on the Throwback Hall. If you know, mind. We're having a good time here. If you haven't come to one of these meetups, come and join us. It's a lot of fun, and you'll enjoy it as well. Take care. See you next time.
Okay, more people showed up. We're setting up one more table. One more table. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 tables. Got to be a record. Yeah, but we're at 19, 20 right now. We'll see.
We're missing Wendy and Lucia.
Oh, so yeah, we're gonna break 20 today. Awesome. Chicken is not pho. No. Chicken is not pho. Chicken is not pho. No.
No pho.
That looks good. What is that? Who ordered that? That's very good. We got a lot of stuff.
Tenderloin salad?
Yeah. Oh, no. Sop shaman.
My usual number 17.
I'm not sure.
And, of course, the iced coffee. All right. So we have a full house. We got 20 people here, right? Over 20. Actually, I kind of got 20. And so we have 7 table. Like I said, the object is to take over this entire patio, and we're going to do that. And, you know, we have over 100 members, but 20 showing up. That's like 20% turnout. That's pretty of the membership. And I'm pretty sure some of those original 100 members were from your blogging group anyway, so I don't know where they are. And we got a few that registered, doesn't even belong to Orange County. They're from Toronto. Someone signed up from Toronto to our meetup group. So maybe one day she'll show up. We don't know. Hopefully one day she'll show up. Yeah, maybe we'll do a remote location. You know, yeah. .com lunch and the CN Tower. I don't know, maybe. Yeah. So you may join me on Skype. Start live feed. We need to talk to Throwback Hall and get him to set up a wireless here, so we can, you know, workshop outdoor. It's 75 right now. Perfect weather. It's great. I mean, yeah, I love it. Last week I was in Chicago, and 93 degrees and it's humid. Once I got out of the airport, and I got to the hotel, I stayed at the hotel for 3 days. Went back to the airport, flew home. Did not see Chicago at all. And what's there to see anyway? I mean, it's Chicago. It's a, you know, city of brothers. They love.
So what's in Wendy's?
Yeah. Home of Wendy's, right?
No, Wendy's.
Home of the Windy City. Oh, yeah. Speaking of the Windy City, the landing. The landing was crazy. See, I swear, I think the pilot was just like, he was bored. Because coming in, the plane was just constantly shaking on the landing. And I was told because O'Hara, Chicago O'Hara, is such a busy airport that they line up one plane after another to land, right? So the plane is in each other's turbulence wake. So coming in, we're always constantly like this, right up to the point we touched down. Even after we touched down, you can see the plane squirming. And I thought that, you know, and I seen my guy sitting next to me go, you know, you think the pilot's just having fun with it? Hey, I'm bored, let's get these hoppers and shake up the yoke a little bit. Yeah. Because it felt like the plane was going to break apart. We did. Yeah. And at one point, we felt like we dropped like 10 feet. I felt like, whoa. Yeah. And then I was told later by Terry Lamb, who used to be a commercial pilot, he said, oh, yeah, he's just following the wake because O'Hara, yeah, the turbulence from the plane behind him. Oh, they're in front of her. The air pocket, that's what's causing it. But flying back home, landing in the OC, Nothing, because, you know, you'll see we're laid back, relaxed, we hang loose here, so, you know. As a matter of fact, you know, the OC Air, right, because Santa Ana Airline, Orange County Airline, is being so close to the main city, you know, and so they have these bylaws. I think the planes don't land after 10 p.m., right? Yeah, the plane cannot land after 10 p.m. because people want to sleep.
And they had to take off
at a certain angle to avoid the noise level, so they don't disturb the city. Because I suppose if you put the airport way, way off in the boonies, you're okay. But you know, the airport's only 5 minutes from me, and I never hear the plane. I don't hear a plane taking off, so it's kind of cool. Yeah. So more of the story. Stick to Southern California. Stay away from the East Coast at all costs. Because, you know, people, I hear they come from the East Coast. I hear them. They never say they never want to move back. People who move back to the East Coast always say, man, I wish I was back in Southern California. I wish I was back in the West Coast. I never seen the other way around. I've never seen people say that, man, I want to move back to Toronto. They want to escape from Toronto. They don't want to move back to Toronto. But people who get transplanted into the East Coast because of work or whatever, they say, man, I wish I was back in Vancouver. I wish I was back in Orange County. Never the other way around. Right. Yeah, because, you know, we have paradise here. Yeah, there you go. Right. So I'm sorry if I just alienated, like, 68% of the population, but, you know, that's too bad.
This is a Brookstone sound ball. I don't know the name of it, but the bop. The bop. B-O-P. By Brookstone. And it has a little attachment suction cup. So I assume that it can get detached. So you could attach it somewhere else, I guess. Very, very slick. And the sound is good.
Yeah, it's somebody's product. What we do is we do
So we're reviewing something from Canon. You can, of course, see their feed on Twitter at @CanonUSA. We have the EOS 6D that we're taking and reviewing. This is a really cool camera. It's one of their newer ones that's out. It's got internal Wi-Fi in it, which is really cool. And it's got your screen on the back and all that good stuff. The other thing that Canon has sent us is their 24 millimeter. This is a really nice millimeter lens. It's a 1.14 stop. And f-stop 2, it's an L. Of course, you can see the beautiful red thing that indicates this is one of their luxury style lenses. Very beautiful, heavy-duty camera. And, of course, you got 20 megapixels. I think it's 20 point something. It's got the Digic 5 Plus chip in it, which is going to get you a huge thing. So beautiful lens, just a giant, beautiful lens to shoot with. A wide angle where you can get really big panoramic pieces, or you can get really close and get great shots with great field of depth stuff. So be sure to check it out. It's $1,700 for the lens, $1,700 for the body. Yeah.
How much the body?
The body's $1,700 for the body.
So $1,700 for the lens, $1,700 for the body.
Mm-hmm. If you go to Canon,
expensive camera.
It's definitely $4,000 you're looking at right here, roughly. I think on Amazon you might be able to get a little cheaper, but you can go to USAcanon.com or you can go to Canon.com if you're international. And search for it. We're going to be putting the review up and reviewing it, but so far we really like it. The pictures that it takes are just top of the line. So great cameras. I love my Canons. Check them out.